So in this video, we are going to learn about the applications of Newton's second law of motion in daily life. So write down application. Of Newton's second law of motion in daily life. So that we are going to discuss today. So there are several applications are there. So first one will take as taking a catch. So you know that in a cricket, the fielder taking a catch. So how the fielder is taking a catch? The fielder is lowering his hand or lowering his arms backward in backward directions of the ball while taking the catch. So question is that why the fielder is lowering his hand at the time of taking the catch. So the fielder, by doing so, increases the time and decreases the rate of change of momentum. So how do you know? From according to the Newton's second law of motion, force F is equal to change in momentum by time. So you can say rate of change of momentum. This is also called the time rate of change of momentum. So if the time is increased, if this time is increased, then what will happen? The force will decrease. Okay. Suppose if I take one example like F is equal to 10 by T. If T is 1, then F will be 10 Newton. Okay. Then if T is 2, then F will be how much? 10 divided by 2, 5. So if the T is increased, the F will decrease. Okay. So that is the thing actually. So what the fielder will do? Fielder will lowering his hand at the time of taking the catch. The rate of change of momentum will decrease and the fielder will not get that much of heart due to the ball. So now if the fielder not takes at the time of taking catch, not lowering his hands backwards, so what will happen? The fielder will rigidly will stop the ball. So in this way he will stop the ball. So now this is the ball. So the ball is coming in this way and he'll how the fielder is taking the catch, he'll catch and they'll pull the ball in this direction. Okay. But if the ball is coming, the fielder rigidly stop this ball, then what will happen? The ball will momentarily come to rest. Okay. That means this time will be zero. Instantly it will come to rest. So as this time is zero, the force will be huge. The force will be more. So entire momentum, okay, of the ball will reduce to zero instantly. So which will cause a large rate of change of momentum. And that the ball would exert a greater force, which might hurt the fielder. Okay. So now see this time become point, suppose what it will do, 10 by T. If this time become like 0.1 second or 0.2 second, then how much? The force will be 100 Newtons. Okay. So that is why if time is less, the force will be more. So that is why the fielder is lowering its hand while catching the ball. So next one is falling of a high jumper on a soft bed. So write down falling of a high jumper on soft bed or sometime you can call it a heap of sand. You have seen this one. So now in high jump activities, the athletes are made to fall on a soft cushioned floor or sand floor. So this will decrease the rate of change of momentum by increasing the time taken. The same type of example also you can say, if someone is fall on a concrete surface, on a very like marble surface or concrete surface, on a floor, so the person will get so much hurt. But if the same person if fall on a sand or you can say on a sponge, okay, so the person will not get that much of hurt. Why? Because when the person will fall, so if it is a concrete surface, momentarily the momentum will come to zero. That means the T will become very, very less. As the T will become very, very less, then the force will become huge. But if the person's after falling on a cushion bed, the person come to rest slowly because he'll compress the cushion bed, so it will take time to come to rest. That means the time will increase. This time will increase, so the force will be decreased. So what we'll write here, if in high jump activities, the athletes are made to fall on a soft cushion floor or you can say the sandy floor, this decrease the rate of change of momentum by increasing the time taken. As the rate of change of momentum is small, so the force due to the fall is small. Thereby, athletes is not hurt. So that you have to write. So now third one is providing shockers. So shockers are like a spring-like structure. Or also if you see the spring-like structures are there in a train also in so many other vehicles. So why they use that spring-like structure? So normally it is connected with a wheel. Okay, suppose there is one structure is there and with that wheel is connected and the shockers will be connected in this type of positions. Now if the shockers are not there, if suppose the this wheel is going to fall on like this type of you can say like the pile of bricks or sometimes the potholes on the road, then what will happen, the rate of change of momentum will be so huge, so this shockers will absorb the shock. That means what, the shocker will compress and again the time will be increased, so the rider will not get so much of hurt due to this. So what will write, and the answer, the shockers are basically spring like structures. The jars are passed to the shockers and then to the body of the vehicles. So this is done to decrease the rate of change of momentum by increasing the time interval and thus reducing the impact force during the jars. So this also reduces the dangerous shocks when the vehicles moves over uneven roads. Okay, so this is the thing. Then next one is very, very important one. So packing glass wires with a soft material. Packing glass wire with soft material. So all the examples, the explanation are same for all the cases. Everywhere you have to use the second law of motion. So breakable materials like china clay and the glass wires are wrapped in paper or straw or air bubble sheet to avoid any breakage during the transportation. So suppose there are two cups are there, this one china clay cups, this is one cup and there is another cup. Now that is in a packing box, we are transporting this one, so without using any kind of wrapper or anything. So what will happen when this cup will hit this cup, because there is time of jerking, when the transport, the jerking will be there and the time will be very less, so that the force will be huge, so this crap, this two cups may breaks into two pieces. Now if I put some like something like paper or some straw inside or air bubble sheets inside. So at the time of jerking, so they may get collide with each other, but time of collision will increase. So again, the time will increase. This time will again increase. This time will again increase. As the time will increase, so rate of change of momentum will decrease. So the impact will be less. So what I told you, how to write the breakable materials like china clay, glass wires are wrapped in a paper or straw or air bubble sheet to avoid breakage during transportation. The package wire, the or can say the glass or the china clay materials are collided due to the jerks during the transportation, but the soft packing material reduce the rate of change of momentum by reducing the impact force. So that is the thing. And also some examples are also there, same type of thing, providing springs in car seats, providing spring car seats, same type of explanation, same thing, just to increase the compression of the seat spring. When some body sits on the seat, increases the duration in which the passenger settles to the seat. This makes the rate of change of momentum lesser, reducing the force which prevents the passengers from hurting themselves. And our next one is stopping slowly after a finishing race. So this is five, no? This is five. Then this is six. Stopping slowly after finishing race. So what is this? So an athlete takes keeps on running even after crossing the finishing line. It is done to decrease the rate of change of momentum by increasing the time interval and thus the reducing the impact force, and this will avoid any injury due to the possible fall in case of athletics tries to stop immediately. Or same thing, you can see if someone is getting down from the running train, so if the person wants to stop immediately because he's just stepped down in the platform and he wants to stop immediately, then what the person will fall. Okay, so then to avoid this type of injuries, this type of accidents, what you have to do, the passenger should run a little bit distance and slowly he should reduce his speed so that he can avoid the injury. Okay, so these are all the things, all the applications. So several other applications are also there. So now you can go through the books. So if any doubt, you can reply in the comment box. So next class we'll continue few more things related to the second law of motion. So thank you very much.